Building SwiftUI apps is a bit like building Lego. You've got a box full of shiny and exciting little building blocks, and it's super easy to get started. You literally just click things together. Like this. But after a while, you might find yourself in the middle of a rather complex build. It sure looks amazing, but once you look under the hood, you realize things have gotten out of hand and it's becoming harder and harder to extend because everything is connected and cross-linked. And that's the moment when you think to yourself, isn't there a better way to do this? If this is you, you've come to the right place. In this series, I'm going to teach you how to create SwiftUI apps that are easy to maintain and extend. We will start at the very beginning and we'll look into how we can refactor an existing SwiftUI app and make it easier to understand, easier to maintain, and easier to extend. In the following episodes, we will build on this knowledge and look into more advanced topics such as handling events and exposing them to the outside world, handling data, making our components customizable, how to distribute our components to other developers, both on our team and outside, and much, much more. So come and join me on this journey to becoming a SwiftUI component building expert. In this episode, we're going to learn how to take an existing UI and refactor it so it becomes reusable. This is the first step on the path to creating a reusable SwiftUI component that you can then share with other developers. So let me quickly grab my machine and let's get started. So here we've got a simple SwiftUI app with a list view as the main UI. In the preview, you can see it's a rather simple UI, just a list of books with their cover image and a few details such as the title and the author. However, if you look at the code, it's already starting to become a little bit complex. And once we start adding new features, this code will quickly start to grow and no longer fit on a single page. So let's look at three different ways to clean up this code and make it more extensible. First of all, let's extract the code that is responsible for drawing the list rows. Xcode has built-in refactoring support that makes this really easy. Just hold down the command key and then click on the view you want to extract, like this. In the context menu, select Extract Subview and watch as Xcode does its magic. We can give this new view a name by typing Book Row View. Now, you will notice that the compiler issues an error saying that book is unknown at this location. We can fix this by defining a property on BookRowView and then passing in the current list element in our for each loop up here. We can use a simple property instead of a binding or state variable because the parent view owns the state. And since the BookRowView doesn't contain any UI elements that allow the user to modify the book, there is no need to synchronize back from the BookRowView to the main view. In future episodes, we're going to implement a SwiftUI component that does allow the user to make modifications, and we'll look at what this means for the view's state handling. Let's finish by moving this code to a new file. And since our view expects a parameter, we'll have to update the preview provider as well and provide a sample book. Finally, let's configure the preview to fit the size of the row and add a preview for dark mode as well. So, Extract Subview is the first tool for refactoring SwiftUI views. The next refactoring I'd like to show you is useful if you have a lot of elements on a view that share the same visual properties. For example, both the author's name and the number of pages have the same font size. To make it easier to update their design in the future, let's extract these two. Now, one way to do this would be to extract them into a subview like we just did. And that's a great idea for views that you might want to reuse in other views. But this time, I'd like to show you another way to do this and keep the code contained in the book row view. To use this refactoring, command-click on the name of the view you want to extract, and then select Extract to Method. This label here displays the detail of a book, so we'll call it Details label. Now, unfortunately, the refactoring didn't move the font view modifier into the method, so I'll have to do that manually. As you can see, the function currently returns a text with the author's name, so in order to make it reusable, we need to make a few modifications. First, let's add a parameter so the caller can pass in a text. Now, let's copy this text here and replace it with the new parameter. Down here, we can now call our new details label function and pass in the text we just copied. And finally, let's refactor the label for displaying the number of pages and make use of our new function. Now, having to specify the text parameter name doesn't look too nice, so let's get rid of the parameter label just like that. Using this technique, we can assign semantic meaning to our UI elements and make them more reusable. For example, it is much easier now to change the appearance of all the detail labels in just one place. The final refactoring makes use of computed properties, and it is most suitable for UI elements that only appear once. Let's take a look. Let me start by defining a new computed property named TitleLabel that returns some view. This tells SwiftUI that the result of this property is going to be some view. It might be a simple view such as a text, but we can also use more complex view structures. In fact, if you compare the signature of this property to the body property, you will notice they're exactly the same. So we're using the same tools as SwiftUI itself. Next, I'll select the two lines that are responsible for displaying the book title and move them into the computed property we just defined. And finally, I can just use the new property in place of those two lines. So, I hope you enjoyed this first part of our journey into building components with SwiftUI. Today, you learned how to refactor an existing SwiftUI view using three different techniques. Extracting a subview is useful for views that you might want to reuse in other areas of your app. Extracting a view into a method is a great technique when you want to make a complex view easier to understand by assigning semantic meaning to the individual subviews. And finally, extracting a view into a computed property is most useful for elements that appear only once. All of those techniques will help us to build complex SwiftUI views and screens more easily, and we'll be using all three of them throughout the series. In the next episode, we're going to build upon our knowledge to create a reusable text input field with a floating label. Now, if you excuse me, I need to fix this Lego bus, which will play an important role in the next episode. Thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next one.